so much. Thank you so much. Maybe a touch more vocals in the monitors up front. Thank you so much for coming out here tonight. This one right here is one of my favorite songs off our new record. It's called Something for Nothing. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm starting to feel warmed up. How about y'all? All right, then. I think it's time we get wild. No more of this half-ass stuff. What do you say? You ready? All right, then. Here we go. I want to hear everybody sing. You ready? I want to thank you all for the food that you made us, but a ton of a can of mama's fried potato. Some pain, cause I don't know how I'm missing things right here. Way out here. I wanna thank you all for the food that you made us, but a ton of a can of mama's fried potatoes. the tomatoes, but a tall hold a can of mama's fried potatoes. Tomatoes, but a ton full of camel mama's fried potatoes. Want to thank you all for the food that you made us, but a ton full of camel. Say hello to Paul, bring it back home. The tomatoes, but a ton of other camel mama's fried potatoes. Say, suck some pork, break some beans, there's a whole lot of missing things around here. Why I'm here. I want to thank you all for the food, the tomatoes, but a ton of other camel mama's fried potatoes. Ladies and gentlemen, how y'all doing tonight? Well, this is the Big Damn Blues Revolution Tour here. And we have tried to put together something really special for you. It is it's kind of a traveling old-time blues review is what it is. And out with us for the last month has been the legendary Mr. Jimbo Mathus and his Tri-State Coalition. And replacing Alvin Youngblood Hart, who was on the first part of this tour, tonight y'all got to see the wonderful, our old pals, Moreland and Arbuckle, who opened up the show. That's right. Old pals ours. Anyway, it's been a damn guitar show so far, you know, and I say, well, let's keep it going. What I want to do right now, if it's okay with everyone here in Chicago, I want to show off on this guitar a little bit. Is that all right? Good, because it's already written in stone. I got to do it, so. All right, here's the deal. Now, what we play here is, and this is there's kind of a sickness in blues music. I think it's a sickness. And the sickness is that not enough people know about the early country blues, the rural blues. And when you're talking about rural blues, the country blues pickers, the best of them, they played the bass with their thumbs and the melody with their fingers at the same time, all right? Without the aid of octave pedals or loop pedals or iPods or laptop computers or special electronics or anything like that, it was six strings plugged into speakers, and that's exactly how we do it. And in case anyone's wondering, this thing's standard tune, E chord, C, D, F, F sharp. Just a regular old six-string guitar. I could pick up any six-string on the planet and do what I'm about to do. So first things first, I'm gonna start off easy, and then I'm gonna make it hard, okay? You follow me here? So here we go. Very simply, my thumb plays bass. And while my thumb's playing bass, my fingers, they play the lead, the melody, at the same time. Here we go. Like I said, I'm gonna start off easy so you can follow along here. Thank you.
of Chicago, Illinois, and folks aren't easily impressed, so I'm going to try one more for you here, all right? Since this is the Blues Revolution Tour and the idea is that it'd be a revolution, I want to say something right now, and I want to play something for you. I come up with things like this in green rooms, like when we're waiting for the show to start. And this one right here I came up with. And I'm going to play a song for you. And it's a song that a lot of blues bands play, all right? Now, I'm not saying all of them, but I'm saying if a blues band plays this next song, 99.9% of the time it means they suck, all right? That's what it means. I'm just being honest with you. It's a fact. So you can tell them I said so. Now, here's the deal. It's because it's not a blues song. It's the theme song to a 1950s television show. And it's also the theme song to a video game from the late 80s, early 90s called Spy Hunter. You remember Spy Hunter? Yeah, Spy Hunter. Yes, yes. You see, you'll recognize the bass line instantly, all right? It goes like this. You recognize it, don't you? Now, usually blues bands, they play this, and they're trying to show off how cool they are, you know. The bass player likes playing this here. And usually bass players in blues bands, they play like this. Let me show you. I'm not wrong, am I? Now, on the other side of the stage, there's usually this lead guitar player. And I don't know why the lead guitar players always stay on the other side of the stage. But anyway, on the other side of the stage, there's this lead guitar player. And he's trying to show off how cool he is. And he plays the lead part. What I'm going to do, while this thing's still standard tune, and here in Chicago, Illinois, is I'm going to play both the bass and the lead to the theme from Peter Gunn right now for you. And hopefully, after all this shit talking I've done, I don't screw it up. So here we go. That. Now it's going to be ruined whenever you see a guitar player just play one thing at a time. I'm sorry about that. Now, I'm going to quit showing off now and get back to singing songs for y'all. This song's about my old pickup truck. It's called Big Blue Chevy 72. Here's the deal. I'm going to level with you, all right? This next song is going to kick ass. You follow me? No, I'm serious. This next song is going to kick ass, but I need your help with it. Because I want it to be better than just kick ass, all right? I want to get it to legendary. I want to see your... Let's see, who's got a drink in their hand right now? Raise it up. Let's see it. Yeah, get up there. Okay, now pound it. Drink it. Right now. You need your hands. You need your damn hands to sing this next song. I'm serious. Pound it. There we go. Sir, what's taking you so long? Could one of these ladies help this guy with his drink right here? Pound it. We ain't got all damn night. That's right. There we go. Okay. All right. Let me check. Let me make sure. Right there. Sir, you don't need a straw, do you? Who's got a drink? All right. We're good. Okay. Now. When I sing clap your hands, y'all are gonna clap your hands like this. Clap them. Harder. Harder. Everybody. That means you right there. Yes. Hang on. Just her. Just her. No, that was five. It's four. One, two, three, four. Let's see it again. There you go. Okay. All right. Now we're all in. Okay. Second verse. When I sing stomp your feet, y'all stomp your feet like this. Stomp them. Harder. I want to hear them boots. Let's hear them. Yeah, that was pretty good. That was pretty good. All right. Third verse. It gets harder every time. When I sing scream out loud, you will. I heard two people screaming. I heard a few hollering. I heard a lot of hooting. I mean, scream like your hair is on fire. Scream out loud. That is more like it. Okay. No more dress rehearsal. This is the real deal now. Let me just get my bass player warmed up. Hang on a second. There we go. Here she goes. Here we go.
Thank you.
your feet. Well, I'm glad you know it, stomp your feet. Well, I'm glad you know it, stomp your feet. Well, I'm glad you know it, stomp your feet. Well, I'm so misunderstood, but I'm trying to be good. Thank you so much. Hang on a second here. I gotta tune this guitar here to evil. Hang on a second. I gotta tune it to evil. Hang on. Evil. Everything you play on it when it's like this is evil. You can't help it. Tommy Johnson, he sold his soul to the devil to learn this tuning. All I had to do was listen to the record. He got the short end of that stick, didn't he? Anyway, this song right here, this song has an awesome music video for it. We made a music video, it's really cool. If you like cool things and you have the internet, you should look at it. The song isn't bad itself, it's called Devils Look Like Angels.
The devil's right here, doing very well.
tell, hard to tell, when the devils look like angels and angels look like hell. Hard to tell when the devils look like angels and angels look like hell.
Thank you so much. Yeah, Tommy Johnson, he got the short end of that stick. I think all the devil taught him was a down to one string. Ain't that a something? This is a three-string cigar box guitar. And, you know, there's like a lot of people have been playing cigar box guitars lately. It's been kind of like a resurgence of them. And I've had a few given to me by different, like, guitar makers and fans and stuff across the country. And this one was a gift. And I like playing this one because it's so crude. Most of them are made out of, like, wooden cigar boxes. This one's cardboard. Most of them have some kind of neck that's been fashioned. This is a 1x2. It runs the strings over top of two bolts. See this? The nut is actually a nut. I mean, it's crude. It's absolutely crude. There's no special pickup system in it. It is three strings run across a stick glued to a box, literally. And I play this this next song we're going to do. I play it on the record the same way. And, you know, it sounds on the record like it's a Les Paul and a bass player. But it's not, it's just this thing right here. I'm gonna prove it to you. The song's called Easy Come, Easy Go.
say all that they have to say. Well, I can't please them all anyway.
Please say
gentlemen, thank you so much. I want to do a crazy one right here. This is one of the craziest finger-picking slide guitar compositions you're ever going to hear. It is insane. And it's just now getting nice enough to really be playing it again. It's called Shut the Screen. That's right.
It's too damn hot, and the bugs too damn bad.
Open the door.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. Now this is a part of the show, the time where I change things up a little bit. What I want to do right now is in a little bit, just a minute, I'm going to bring out some pals with me. And I'm going to bring out my pal, Jimbo Mathus. And I'm going to also have Mr. Arbuckle from Moreland Arbuckle come join me on stage, you know what I mean? But first things first, I want to go back to the beginning. I want to take y'all right back to the beginning, all right? And the beginning is Charlie Patton. Yeah! Yes, that is the proper response right there. Yes. You see, a lot of people don't know who the hell Charlie Patton is. And it's a shame because he's the most important person in American music history over the last 115 years. And if you don't believe me, look it up. Without Charlie Patton, there would be no Robert Johnson, no Muddy Waters, no Howlin' Wolf, no Chuck Berry, no Beatles, no Rolling Stones, no John Fogerty, no Reverend Peyton. God forbid. But anyway, you look him up. But first things first, I want to play one of his songs for you. This song is really a collection of old spiritual songs. The record label called it Prayer of Death, Part 1. That's right, Prayer of Death, Part 1.
Take a stand. And if I never ever see you anymore, take a stand. And I will meet you on that other shore. Hear my hand. And if I never ever see you anymore, well, Have his word. And if I never ever see you anymore, why, have his word. And how he'll miss you on that other show.
Have to the stage, Mr. Jimbo Mathus, Mr. Dustin Arbuckle, and I think Breezy's going to come help us sing too on this song.
Yeah, Breezy! Yeah!
that might not be rain.
It's beer.
There's bathrooms up there. Ladies and gentlemen, as these fellows are plugging in and tuning up and everything, I'm going to brag on them a little bit. Mr. Arbuckle right here has been one of our pals for a long time. Longer than 8 years, I guess. Yeah, longer than 8 years.
2005.
And, but anyway, an old pal. And Jimbo Mathus back here, getting his mandolin out. He has been one of my absolute heroes. I want to tell a story about him. You see, one time I went on a date with this gal named Breezy, right? And she says to me, she says, "So what kind of music you like listening to?" And I said, "Well, I like lots of old blues, old country blues. And lots of stuff like, you know, my favorite's Charlie Patton. You probably never heard of him." And she said, "Oh yeah?" And she pulls out this CD, and it's Jimbo Mathus CD, Songs for Rosetta. And that's Songs for Rosetta Patton, mind you. Now, when I heard that, and there was this gal that knew who Charlie Patton was, and this record that you know was so influenced by Charlie, and at least acknowledged who he was, and it was so good, and I mean, I'm telling you what, my life was never the same after that day, ever. So it's been an absolute honor having these fellas out on this tour with us. And we're going to do a song right now, actually off of Songs for Rosetta. And Jimbo's going to lead us on it. And it's influenced by Charlie, but the main chorus, the main line, "Who will sop my gravy," that's 100% Jimbo Mathus. So anyway.
Amen, Reverend. Thank you. We're on a higher plane tonight. Indeed, we're on a higher power tonight. Play that lunar note and let it float, Reverend. Thank you. Vicksburg on a high heel, mama. Jackson down below, yeah. Vicksburg on a high heel, mama. Jackson down below. I can tell by the way you would treat me. Baby, you don't let me no more. Who's gonna stop my grave when I'm dead gone? Sometimes I wonder, who's gonna stop my grave when I'm dead gone? Sometimes I wonder, yeah. Who gon' feed my pony? Baby, when I'm moving. Baby, when I'm moving. Baby, when I'm moving on. The great philosophical question, who will stop my gravy when I'm dead?
Yeah, man. Don't you love that Charlie Patton picking, man? That's like the coolest thing ever thought
taking
of.
Taking us back to the old times.
That's the coolest thing ever thought of.
Yes, it was. It's one of the greatest inventions of the modern civilization right there. Right?
Well, I'm going to set this guitar down, and I'm going to pick up another one. And I think we're going to bring Cuz back here, and let's do a Bo Diddley song. Gentlemen, we celebrated this week Muddy Waters' 100th birthday. Would have been. And the thing about it is that I have a version of Bo Diddley and Muddy Waters doing this song, and it's so cool. It's so good. And but the thing is, neither one of them wrote it. It was written by a fellow by the name of Willie Dixon. And I bet some people here in Chicago know who Willie Dixon was. He was one of the greatest American songwriters that ever lived. But anyway, on this record, Muddy Waters, he says to Bo Diddley, he says, "You ain't no man. I'm a man amongst men." I love that so much. That was so cool. So I want to dedicate this to Muddy Waters. So. Even though Bo Diddley's more famous for doing it. It's a song that I live every single day. It's called You Can't Judge a Book by Its Cover.
Preach on, Reverend, preach on.
We ready?
Yes, sir.
Well, you can't judge an apple by looking at the tree. You can't judge a honey by looking at the bee. You can't judge a daughter by looking at her mother. You can't judge a book by looking at the cover. Oh, now, can't you see? You best judge me. I look like a farmer, but I'm a lover. You can't judge a book by looking at the cover. Judge a fish by looking at the pond. You can't judge a right by looking at the wrong. You can't judge a wrong by looking at the other. You can't judge a book by looking at the cover. Oh, now, can't you see? You best judge me. I look like a farmer, but I'm a lover. You can't judge a book by looking at the cover. We'll be right back.
judge a sugar by looking at the cane. You can't judge a woman by looking at her man.
Hell no.
You can't judge a woman by looking at the other. You can't judge a book by looking at the cover. No, can't you see? Yeah.
You can't judge me.
I look like a farmer, but I'm a lover. Can't judge a book by looking at the cover. No.
Makes me feel good. We'll bring Mr. Arbuckle back up here to help us. And Jimbo's going to lead us in this one here. This is an old song that a lot of people have done versions of, but Jimbo's is one of the best. And I'll let him describe the song. He has a good way of describing what this song's about.
Well, thank you, Reverend. You know, I try to put it succinctly. This song is about a game of chance interrupted by, in an African-American community, interrupted by law enforcement, prematurely. In other words, it's a dice game that got busted up by the police. Oh yes, and we like to bring out the kazoo on here, for those of you
who it legal? Is it legal to play a kazoo in Chicago, Illinois, actually?
You can't smoke things.
There's
out
not
of a
lot legal here, actually.
This kazoo is actually not legal.
That's a contraband kazoo there.
It's one of those funny kazoos. But Reverend, I appreciate that. And everybody, I just want to say from the bottom of my heart, thank you, Reverend Cuz, Miss Breezy, of course, for having Jimbo Mathus' band and doing this great tour we're doing to Blues Revolution. And it's on and popping, so y'all tell your friends, and if you don't tell your friends, your grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and great-great-great-great-grandchildren will find you remiss. and future generations for this uncalled for neglect in their education. Am I right, Reverend?
You are 100% correct, as usual.
Oh, hell, if you believe that bullshit, then we're gonna try this here.
What's up?
Wow, really?
Sorry, this old guitar is being naughty.
Come on now. Come on now. Are you feeling the spirit there, Dustin? Are you feeling the spirit?
I'm feeling the spirit. Are you feeling the spirit?
I'm feeling the spirit tonight.
Are y'all feeling the spirit?
We want to know if you got the spirit in you.
I'm feeling
the
spirit.
Do you have the spirit?
Spirit
from on high. If I'm wrong, are we not really kind of near the sort of the cathedral of baseball? Would you say that? Could you say that? It kind of is. Even if your thumbs are down, you're probably wrong. It sort of is, all right? Even if you don't care whether or not this team wins or loses, it don't matter. This is kind of a cathedral of baseball, really is. It really is. It is. You got to admit. So at the foot of this cathedral of baseball, We're going to play an old spiritual song for you. And I don't care what you believe in. It could be the giant purple people eater. I don't give a damn. If this song don't make you feel good, you are not alive anymore. That's what I have to say about it.
I actually do believe in the giant purple people eater.
I meant no offense by that.
None taken.
A powerful deity.
Purple people eater is my people.
Well, every night I do a different intro to this song. And tonight I feel like doing the super happy intro.
Yes, 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 yes. Yes, I like that.
of Jimbo Mathus and the Tri-State Coalition. Mr. Arbuckle, Dustin Arbuckle from More Than an Arbuckle. I'm Reverend Peyton, y'all. This is my big damn band. Thank you so much. Thank you all so much. Thank you so much. If you put it like that, we might have time for one more. What do you say? Let's close things out with a slow, somber waltz tonight. Slow, somber waltz to close things out? Are you sure? Two bottles of wine, is that what you want to hear? Is that what's going on? All right then two bottles of wine you shall get. But here's the deal. I don't want some half-assed version of this song. You hear what I'm saying? When I sing two bottles of wine, y'all yell back. Only not half-assed like that. Everybody and all at once, let's practice. Two bottles of wine.
Two bottles of wine.
Two bottles of wine.
Two bottles of wine.
No, 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 no. Louder!
Two bottles of wine.
Two bottles of wine.
Two bottles of wine.
Uh-oh. Let's try it again louder. Two bottles of wine.
Two bottles of wine.
Two bottles of wine.
Two bottles of wine.
Two bottles of wine. All right, cuz. Hit it! The legendary, the absolutely legendary with the sweetest teeth. Give him a smile, Jimbo. Let's see that gold tooth. Look at that. Breezy won't let me have a gold tooth. I'm so jealous. I love this guy. Mr. Jimbo Mathus right here. Jimbo Mathus and the Tri-State Coalition. They're over there hanging out. We're going to be over there hanging out too, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Reverend Peyton. This is my big damn band, y'all. Thank you so much.